Okay, so in continuation with the last session, Sinolid gives sin and aldol. Okay, now we will see how the transsinolid gives the anti-aldol. Okay, so very easy, it's not that of difficult. Just pay attention on the formation of the enolate geometry. Okay, one moment, please. So we'll see now. Now here is the transenolate. How to draw the transenolate first? So as we have seen, everything is depend upon the enolate geometry. So we are going to write down the trans. Okay. So this one is carbon-carbon double bond. Pay attention. Carbon-carbon double bond. This is the carbon-carbon double bond. So methyl group we have to pay attention. Bulkiest group should be on opposite side. So here is the methyl is bulky on this carbon atom. So methyl he is here is bulky and here is the carbon oxygen we have to consider as the bulkiest compared to the X. So this carbon oxygen and methyl they are on opposite side of this carbon-carbon double bond. Okay. So just consider carbon-carbon double bond in whenever you are writing the cyclic transition state chair conformation. So carbon methyl group and carbon oxygen O minus containing group they are on opposite side of this enolate carbon-carbon double bond. So this is transenolate. Okay. Now we are going to vary the position of this R group, which is present on the second mole of aldehyde. Okay. So only we have to change the position of R group whenever we are going to write two different forms of the this cyclic transition state, chair conformation of cyclic transition state. So in first conformation I have written alkyl group at pseudo-equatorial position, and in another second conformation I have written alkyl group at the axially I have put it pseudo-axial position. But again alkyl group bulky group at the axial position, and again at third position axially situated X, that one is creating steric hindrance. That's why this cyclic transition state is disfavored. And where alkyl group from the aldehyde as at pseudo-equatorial position, as well as methyl group is also at equatorial position. So this is a little bit more favorable compared to this conformation, chair conformation. Okay, so we have to consider, or we have to consider this one is the stable intermediate cyclic transition state rather than this. Okay, so which one is a stable cyclic transition state? That one is getting react next, and here methyl group, pay attention again, transenolate methyl group and CO group, they are opposite to this carbonyl carbon-carbon double bond. And now bond making and bond breaking happens. Now new bond lithium has been shifted from this enolate oxygen to the carbon aldehyde oxygen. Okay, lithium has been shifted over here. New carbon-carbon single bond has been formed in between two carbon atoms. So new carbon-carbon bond has been formed. Now pay attention, orientation of methyl group, that one is pointing above the plane, that means upward, pointing upward. So here whenever you are writing this conformation, so methyl group is pointing upward, so we have to show that one is above the plane. And here hydroxyl group pointing, it is equatorial pointing, so that we have, that one is present below the plane of this molecule. So hydroxyl group present below the plane, so in this way we got anti-aldol. Okay, very easy. If you will pay proper attention, if you know the basic requirement for the chair conformation and this thing, so everything is easy, not that of difficult. Okay, so this is the way, in this way we got anti-aldol. So overall reaction is here. Okay, the diastereoselectivity is due to the formation of cyclic six members transition state, which is also called Zimmermann triangular transition state, in which the bulky group of carbonyl compound favorably takes pseudo-equatorial position. Okay, bulky group of the carbonyl compound. So this is bulky group of the carbonyl compound. It takes the pseudo-equatorial position. Okay, on the enolate, bulky group on the enolate has to take pseudo-axial position, and enolate that is taking pseudo-axial position in case of cis enolate. Okay, so this is cis form of the enolate, carbon-carbon double bond, methyl group and oxygen, this carbon oxygen on the same side of this carbon-carbon double bond, cis enolate O minus and methyl group they are on the same side of this carbon-carbon double bond. Okay, so pseudoxial position, this leads to the syn product. Okay, so this is the overall reaction. Here is the syn or erythroketol. Okay, ketol, hydroxyl and methyl group, they are present, both they are present below the plane of the paper. So pay attention, methyl group plane in this pointing downside, so below the plane. Here this now here we have this oxygen is turning to the hydroxyl group, that one is present, that one is pointing below the plane. So that one is also hydroxyl present, that one is also, we can say, it's present below the plane. So this is our final product with the syn hydroxyl beta hydroxy compound. Okay, so now we will see one more example in case of cyclic ketone. Okay, cyclic ketone, one cyclic we have taken. So pay attention, this is trans singulate actually now. Okay, carbon carbon double bond, consider this one O minus, and this carbon CH2 group is now another bulky substituents. They are present opposite to each other, trans singulate. Pay attention how I have written the cyclic transition state. So phenyl, so don't consider this phenyl, carbonyl, this carbon oxygen, lithium, and this methyl group, they are present opposite to each other of this carbon carbon double bond. This is the carbon carbon double bond, and now we have to put phenyl at pseudo equatorial position. Okay, and after bond making and bond breaking, we can see this one present above the plane, okay, and hydroxyl present below the plane. Okay, so this one we have to show above the plane. So I have written here wedge bond above the plane. This methyl group we have to show with wedge bond, and hydroxyl group present below the plane. Okay, so here we got anti-3O ketone, anti or 3O ketone. So very easy, if you will go through proper writing down the cyclic transition state with the cis and trans enolate, then you can predict any type of product of this stereoselective aldol reaction.